Hello everyone, so today we're gonna make creme brûlée, like this one, with a thin caramel. It's very good. It's very creamy as well. It's delicious. It melts, it's creamy. Beautiful. So let's make some. So it's very easy. So what you're gonna need, it's a pan, obviously. We're just gonna make a small recipe. So we're gonna need some whipping cream, 550 grams. There. And then we're gonna need, just to give a bit of lightness, 200 grams of milk, whole milk. There's probably thousands of recipes for creme brûlée, but this is mine. One vanilla pod, for this quantity, one vanilla pod. More vanilla pod there is, better it is. So cut it in half, then we scrape the seeds out. It's a nice vanilla pod. Up, put that in your cream and milk. With this one too. Chick chick. And that goes on the stove. We give it a boil, let the vanilla infuse. And meanwhile, we're gonna do our yolks with the sugar. So for this recipe, we need 8 yolks. So which is 20 grams per yolk, so it's gonna be 160 grams. What were you looking for? Box. So 160 grams of yolks. Remember, we need to shake it to separate it easier. What's so funny? Hop. So there's a beautiful free-range eggs, local. I see this one, I didn't shake it. I'm just thinking of it. Okay, 160 we need, yeah? Two more. Yeah. Okay, up. So we keep the white. So that's our yolks. So in 260 yolks, we're gonna put 1 to 5 of caster sugar. There. And we're gonna give it a whisk. Until it goes slightly white, so well mixed. Voilà, so that's it. So now we are just waiting for our cream to boil, and we are nearly there. Okay, so the cream is boiling. So if you boil the cream with the vanilla pod the night before, and you reserve it in the fridge, then it will infuse even more, so the flavor will be even better. So we pour half of the cream milk in your yolks. Stir it nice. But because we're gonna have to bake it in the oven 100 degrees after, into the little dishes, I'm just gonna quickly help it to cook, to bake quicker. So I'm just gonna cook it as a crème anglaise, a custard, just to thicken a bit more. Then it'll be much faster to cook in the oven. We could cook it from that stage, pour it in the dishes, and bake it at 100 degrees, but it will take much longer, obviously. So I just help it. But be careful, don't go over 83 degrees at this stage, otherwise it goes crumble. So we have left the vanilla. Now it's about 80-85 degrees, so I remove it from the stove. And I just carry on till it thickens even more. There we are. So now it's thick. It's much thicker. See, if you do a line, the line stays. So we are good. We're gonna fill up our dishes now. So we got some little terracotta dish. We can remove the vanilla now. Squeeze it up. It's very hot. Oh, we can do even two more, maybe. I got only one. So it's gonna be one more. We need to order some more. They're coming from Spain, so it takes quite a while to come here in UK. Oh, shame. Well, we're gonna put it in that tiny dish. That will be for us. There we go. So all of that lot can go in the oven, a convection oven, a deck oven at 100 degrees. As long as 100 degrees, we are fine. And for probably around 40 minutes, 1 hour, there we go. So now our little crème brûlée are cold. So it's time to caramelize it. So blue torch, and I'm doing it with demerara sugar, but not over too much, really. Some people put quite a lot and caramelize it, and then it becomes very thick and black. I don't like it so much. What I'm doing, I put quite a lot of sugar on top, flatten it up a bit, and tip it over. So then it's just a thin, wipe the sides and caramelize it. I have no gas. I have no gas. Oh no. Let's get another one. Boom. Someone left it open. That's why. So from not too close, from far, as it melts gently. It has a nice color, because if you go too close, it will burn. There we go. That's all.